Record. Here we go.
Yeah.
Okay, Nancy, back. Hello, welcome. Hello, Bress. James. Sue Erickson's. Yep. Okay, muy bien. Peggy, have you got sound now? I think not yet. Okay. Not yet. Todavía no. All right. Okay, good. Any questions as we get started? Wait for everybody else to arrive. ¿Preguntas? Nancy, ¿cómo estuvo la semana? Estuvo. Bien. You're on mute, my dear.
There you
There
go.
you
Wouldn't let me
go.
unmute. I took William to Arlington on Monday for his asylum interview.
Okay. Well, fantastic. Like at the Pentagon or what?
It's right across the river from the White House.
Wow, and how did it go?
He thinks it went well.
Okay, beautiful. Good job. You're a good person. That's fantastic.
So I
Okay.
have a question. You're recording these. Are the recordings available after the fact?
Generally, yes, we put them in our YouTube channel and usually also in the Facebook group.
Excellent.
Yeah, and also the document. Have you been here before, Sue?
No, this is the first time. I keep forgetting.
Okay, all
You
right.
know, until 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and I'm busy doing something else, and I go, oh, wait.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, 4 o'clock Pacific. We do that because if we do it any later, then it gets too late on the East Coast.
Yes, right.
Yeah. Okay, well, glad you're here. Bienvenida. ¿Cómo está tu español? Okay. Let's see.
But hopefully I'm
I'm
okay.
gonna mute. Did you mute them, Anna?
No.
No? Okay. All right. Muy bien. Okay. So, anybody else new? Is this everybody else has been here before? Mary, you have been here before? ¿Has estado aquí antes? I don't know. Okay, so we're going to go through a lot of examples here tonight. Feel free to participate or not. You can just sit back and listen and watch. There will be translations from English to Spanish and from Spanish to English, and plenty of opportunity for questions. Okay, so, Sue, ¿cómo está tu español ahora? ¿Estás aprendiendo español o habla mucho?
Un poco, estoy, fácil, leo, pero hablar y, escuchar, no.
No mucho, no mucho. Okay, this is going to be great for you. Good. Okay, bienvenida. Welcome. Hillary Lee.
Gracias.
Peggy, you got sound? She's been here for 10 minutes, so I'm keep checking in with her to like see how it's going. All right. Okay, Bryce, if anybody's new, James Roseborough and I are both Jameses, and we call him Bryce. And I hope he doesn't mind. If you mind, I'll go back to James.
4K.
No, it's fine.
4K with Bryce.
His middle name.
Oh.
Yes, my middle name.
Oh,
Other people call him Bryce sometimes.
muy bien.
Or used to. Okay.
Are you?
Muy bien.
Where are you
Excelente.
located?
Who are you asking?
Who?
Bryce.
Me?
Oh.
Oh, Bryce, I'm located in Columbia, South Carolina.
Can't
Not
you
that far from
tell?
me.
Can't you tell?
White
Got
time zone.
that Carolina accent.
I think you're the first person that's ever told me that, but I'll take it.
Okay.
Okay, well,
and
you help
drawl it
yourself to
out.
that. Yes,
What
I
car
am.
are
It's
you?
great. It's great. Okay, Richard's iPad. Something tells me you're not Richard.
No, I'm Joan.
Joan? Okay, do you mind if I change your name on the window here?
Be my guest.
Great. Okie
Thank you.
dokie. Thank you. Welcome. Have you been here before?
Yes,
Okay.
maybe one or two.
Okay. All right. I'm sorry if I forget. I'm old. I forget. Okay. Bev made it. Joan, welcome. All right. Here we go. Bryce, what are we? He left. Safeway.
James, goodness is this.
Entonces. Hey, Anna, Dennis was asking, Dennis, what's the name of the town?
Esquipulas, I believe.
Esquipulas?
Esquiui
In Managua?
in Nicaragua.
Yeah, in Managua.
I'm sorry, where?
We don't know, but
In Managua. In Managua. That is in
oh, it is.
Managua.
Okay.
Okay.
It's
Esquipulas.
we call it municipio. It's like a town in Managua. Yeah.
Great.
So okay. It's a
His cunada is from there.
okay. It's a small town.
Yeah.
Very small town. So you were there?
No.
No, okay.
Ellos, ellos, allá, aquí, or now, ahora, they spend the winter down there. My wife,
Okay.
my husband, my br brother, and sister-in-law.
Excellent.
I bet so they spend the winter there.
Yes.
I'm sorry. So, you know what happened is in
That's right.
Managua, it's
For
very
you,
hot.
that's here. Yes.
Yeah, it's
Okay.
very hot, like horrible. Okay. So, and the
What would
winter
be the
there.
right way to phrase that?
What exactly? What?
They spend the winters there.
Near
They spend the
Managua.
winter.
Ellos están pas in present, it will be ellos están pasando el invierno aquí or. Ellos in past, ellos pasaron el invierno aquí. But since you can say only ellos the winter, is the whole winter or just this month?
The month, a number of months. I don't know how many.
Okay, yeah. So you can say that. Let me write it. Ellos, I bet they are cold. Pasando el invierno aquí. Okay.
Well, the
It's
rest
the
of the time
stand pass.
they live in Wisconsin, so cold isn't a problem.
Okay.
Right.
That's good.
It
It
would
would be IE, wouldn't it? There?
No,
Or IE?
because Anna's there.
Oh. Yeah, this is for Dennis. That's how he will say it. Yeah.
Muy bien. Okay, entonces, James, what do you have teed up for us today?
Okay, what we're going to do today is just a couple of basic things. I did examples with the verb dar or to give, and also for the verb decir, which, to say. And the reason why I did that is just because a few people last week said they had some confusions as far as some of the conjugations between the two. Like, say, for example, D, mean, like I gave past tense, but D in the present first means, like tell me, like dime, So
Dime,
I did those
dime.
and I did with dijo versus dio, dijimos versus dimos, dijiste. Versus diste, just, and I did a couple with day because people were saying something about some examples with day. But unless they're specific, I mean, it's hard for me to give an example on everything they want. I just gave some examples using using day. But
Okay.
unless someone says something specific, it's hard to key indirectly on what they want, because day is used in many different instances. So.
Maybe maybe these sentences will cause some of those specific questions.
Okay.
Aquí tenemos Peggy otra vez. Charlotte. Charlotte's coming in. Okay, Roger.
Hola,
Bienvenido.
hola.
¿Cómo
¿Cómo
estás?
están? ¿Cómo les va?
Excelente, excelente.
Roger. ¿Qué tal? Buenas tardes,
Ustedes están
buenas tardes.
practicando juntos, ¿verdad?
Sí,
Sí.
señor.
Okay, that's great. Good, good. Okay. And how is the practice going?
Good. Yeah.
Great. All right. Well, here we go. Number one. So what we do here for anybody who's new is just kind of raise your hand or volunteer if you would like to try and translate this either from, whatever. So, yeah, Dennis, go ahead. What is number one?
Dime exactamente lo que piensas. Tell me exactly what you think.
Right, but say dime, dime.
Dime.
Right, so
Oh,
the
sure, yeah.
dime, so say it again.
Dime exactamente lo que piensas.
In English, it's
Tell me exactly what you think.
And so, Anna, when we looked at this earlier, Anna's like, "Are you sure?" So, all right.
Just one thing I wanted to say real quick on
Go for
dime. Of course, sometimes you may hear someone say dígame, formally. A lot of times when you say something to someone, hey, I got a question for you. Hey, I want to tell you something or look, and first thing they'll say is dime. So you'll hear that a lot. So
Like, hey, Bryce, dime. It's like, tell
dime.
me, right?
Yep.
Dime.
And what's the difference with dígame?
That's just formally when you're,
Formal, formal. Okay.
yes.
And do you just have to know that there's a low, that what you think it, or you just have to know
Loque, that which.
that would.
That which. It's just a
All right.
different construction.
Okay, that much. Okay. So it's not it, it's that which. Okay.
Kind of. It's not which either. I mean, that what? If it's literally, tell me exactly that what you think. So it's just a different construction, but you do need the low in there. Okay. All right. Okay. Who would like to tackle number two?
I can go.
Okay.
Lace de ellos, todo el tiempo que ellos necesitaron. Up the top one, okay.
So close. Yes, and the ellos is optional because why?
Give lace in front.
Yeah, less implies them, and necesitaban it also implies them, so that's optional.
Also, it's very redundant in Spanish if you use the subject twice, very close. So it's better if you only use one. Les di a ellos todo el tiempo que necesitaban, or les di todo el tiempo que ellos necesitaban. Either one, but no both.
Would be the same. All
It's
right.
redundant
Yes.
if you use both. Okay.
Okay. Anything you're particularly trying? Less D,
No, I just wanted to
Bryce?
see the D versus D me in the first In the first one, there's two different D's. Of course, D may tell me, but you know, D by itself, you know, say, you know, just so because people said it confused them. But honestly, for context, once you get better with these things, for context, you'll easily be able to understand that. Just with more practice, because the context of the conversation, when you hear someone say "Dime exactamente lo que piensas," you know, as you get better, you're not going to be thinking "dar."
Right. It's not "give me exactly what you're thinking." I guess. Tell me, give me. Okay. Excellent. Numero tres. Hello, Ken. How are you today?
Hello, James and everybody. How are you?
Doing great.
Can I try number three?
Sure. Sorry, I picked on Ken. Go ahead.
Me dieron todo lo que pedí. In English, it'd be they gave me everything. I need it. No, I need
ask it. For.
Ask. Yeah, I ask for it. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, say the Spanish sentence again, please.
Okay, so me dieron todo lo que pedí, right?
Okay, one thing is pedí, so the accent is on the last pedí, and it's not me, it's what?
Me.
Me dieron.
Me dieron.
Todo.
Todo.
Say the rest.
Lo que pedí.
Excellent. Good job. All right. They gave me everything I asked for. Okay. Cool. Any questions there? Anybody? Okay. Dieron. Me dieron. That's past tense. They gave me. All right. Number four, let me just ask, iPhone Kin, are you here? Do you have a camera? Can we hear you? What's your name?
I'm really brand new to learning Spanish, so this is too high for me. I can't go through with this.
Oh, just listen. Yeah, welcome.
That's
welcome.
Why. Okay.
It's
thank
okay.
You.
Don't worry. No te preocupes. What's your name?
Okay.
My name is Kin.
Kin?
Khin, yes.
Okay, excellent. Nice to meet you. Welcome.
Nice to see you too. Nice to see you all.
Okay. All right. Okay, go ahead, number four.
¿Te dieron a qué hora empieza la fiesta?
Was that too easy? You're like, good job. Good now, job.
For those, it's just to get used to the sound of diero versus dijero. Just to get used to, because they do sound similar. They do sound similar when you hear a person speaking real fast, but just to get used to, you know, diero, dijero.
¿Te dijeron a qué hora empieza la fiesta? Great. Good job. Any questions on this one? Did they tell you?
Dijeron is what? That's that from Decir?
Yes.
Decir. Yes.
Yeah, it's the past.
So that's kind of saying, did they say to you? Did they tell you? Yes. Decir. Number five.
This is Hillary. I would like to try this one, please.
Okay, Nancy, we'll catch you next.
Okay. Nos dio instrucciones de cómo hacerlo. They told us, they gave us instructions of how to do it.
Okay. I'm gonna substitute four in there, de como. Or it could be on, could be
Yes,
four,
sometimes
could
we
be
say on.
on how to do it, instructions on. How about that?
Okay.
But it's of, yeah,
It
but
is a little difficult. It's
nos dio, they gave us, nos dio instrucciones.
how come deal is they?
No, well,
The nos is they. Over he.
nos is
Nos is
us.
he. It's
Gave
he. It's yes,
us.
he gave us.
Oh, it
Or
should
he
be,
or she.
gave
Gave
us.
us.
Yes, it should be
Deal.
he gave us.
He, she.
Or she.
Oh, gosh.
Good job. He, she gave us. Right? Instructions. Yeah. Okay. Good job. So how would we say they? Sue?
Dion,
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 Dieron.
oh, Dieron,
No.
no,
It's
Dieron,
close. She's
Dieron. Oh, okay, Dieron.
let's look at let's so this is kind of what Bryce was saying just a second ago. The difference between dijeron and dieron,
Hard to hear.
especially if Anna says it or Roger. Where did
It's easy
Roger?
to get it. Dieron, dijeron. No, the G sound is very strong.
Yeah, Roger, Roger, por
Yep.
favor, lee número cuatro en español y número cinco en español, just solo para pronunciar.
Okay. Te dijeron a qué hora empieza la fiesta. Ahora voy un poco más lento. Te dijeron a qué hora empieza la fiesta. And the second one, nos dieron instrucciones de cómo hacerlo. Again,
Sí.
nos dieron instrucciones de cómo hacerlo.
Y esas dos palabras dijeron y dieron.
Sound similar.
Yes, para nosotros, sí, es
Sí.
difícil. Okay, entonces, Nancy, you wanted to jump into the next one or?
He's going to be here on Wednesday. Nos dijo que going to be estaría aquí el miércoles.
That's the conditional. Estaría is the conditional.
Okay. Or he's going to be ba. Ba. Location would be a star.
Yes. Good job,
Good
Nancy.
job.
El miércoles.
Excellent. Say the whole sentence again, please. And the
Nos
English.
dijo que va a estar aquí el miércoles.
Good job. Okay. Say the English. Say the English also for everybody.
He told us he's going to be here on Wednesday.
Great. Thank you.
Por qué el instead of en miércoles.
Or leaving it out entirely.
El miércoles, it the Wednesday, on the Wednesday. That is the construction in Spanish.
Okay.
It is what you will hear. So you will hear Spanish speakers often when they're speaking English, they will use, you will hear them say, I will be here the Wednesday. The party is on the Tuesday. And we have to help them not say
The
the, but we have to remember that we do use the, like el miércoles in Spanish. El miércoles. It's the way Spanish is constructed. And it's not en, it's not en.
I'll do number seven.
Okie doke.
Voy a freír huevos por la mañana. I'm going to fry eggs in the morning.
Okay, I want you to say that word again.
Freír.
There you go.
But I hear a lot of times them leaving off the I, or say something like freish. At least with Duolingo.
Okay. Duolingo is fantastic for learning vocabulary. Don't trust it for
pronunciation.
For the pronunciation.
Yeah,
it is a great program. It works for a lot of people for building vocabulary. Listen to the news if you can. Listen to native speakers. Practice with native speakers. That's what ShareLingo do, is connect English and Spanish speakers. I don't want to knock Duolingo. It's good for one thing,
but not another. Yeah.
Trust Anna and whoever you're practicing with. Okay. I'm going to fry eggs in the morning. Okay.
Well, a question.
Yes, please. Go ahead.
Why not by the morning, or can be used by the morning too?
You can. No.
No?
No.
Okay.
In the morning. Okay. Okay. Now, we could say, see, I believe you're thinking of for the morning. We could say for breakfast.
Okay.
I'm going to fry eggs for breakfast. Right? But we would not say for the morning or by the morning.
I think he's thinking more about something like he won't finish the book by tomorrow, for example.
So
it will be ready by Wednesday. Something like that. That use of by plus a day rather than for.
Okay.
So, I don't know what I thought that I need, or I will use by instead of in.
Okay. If I use by, I'm going to be more specific. By 10 o'clock. Okay. I'm going to fry 10 eggs by 10. Just to keep out the 10, by 8 a.m. Okay. I'm going to fry 10 eggs by 8 a.m. Antes de. Okay. Antes de las 8.
Or
you can start frying them right now.
Yes. Or else you're going to fry eggs all night long.
Right. Yes, mm-hmm. We can do that.
Otra variante, si por ejemplo fuera voy a freír huevos, bueno, no, sería, cambiaría un poco, podría ser yo frío huevos por las noches, entonces ahí sería I fry eggs at night, ¿no? Something like that.
I fry eggs at night.
Okay.
That's correct. Sí, es correcto.
I love to behave. Mm-hmm.
Good job.
James, would you use, if you're going to say instead of fry, you know, you don't want to fry eggs now for in the morning because they're going to be disgusting. But if you want to say I'm going to cook eggs, meaning now for the morning, would you still use pour?
Okay, so let's say I'm, there we go. Anna.
La mañana. Voy a cocinar huevos para la mañana.
Para mañana en la mañana, para mañana temprano, para llevar al trabajo. Para.
Para la mañana.
Huevos.
Para mañana.
Just. Okay. Good job. Good questions. Excellent. What are we learning here?
Oh, that one is actually, I'm comparing it to the next one. Because when we give a specific time, then we say they,
I see.
not por or in la mañana.
Okay. Who's doing this one?
Does somebody want to do it, or I can try, maybe?
I could do it.
Go ahead.
I'm going to get up at 6 in the morning. Me voy a levantar a las 6 de la mañana. I had to pick the easiest one.
That's good. Okay.
Damn.
Okay. A las 6 de la mañana. At 6 in the morning. De la mañana. Cool. Good job. Next.
I can try this, but let's see. I told you more than once, but you didn't listen to me.
Who says that?
The
So I told you then once. Te dico, no, how you should say, I told you. Te dico, más de una. Pero no te escucho, no te escucho, escucho, ¿eh?
No me
¿Escuchaste?
escuchaste.
No, sorry. Escuchaste me.
Right, so escuchaste is somebody else. It's you listened, past tense. You listened. Escuchaste, right? Me is who you listened to, right? You didn't listen to me.
Right.
No me escuchaste.
That's just a demonstration of I put in here más de una vez because that it's más de because you're indicating a quantity afterwards. Or más de dos veces, 10 veces, whatever.
Gotcha.
Do you have to have the low in there?
That was my question.
Most of the time, it still makes sense if you said te dije, but a lot of times in spoken Spanish, it's te lo dije, but it still makes perfect sense if you say te dije without the lo.
Isn't there another idiom for not listening to me? I can't think of the word right now.
Thinking of oír? You thinking of oír like no me oíste?
No, that's not what I'm thinking of. Oh, well, never mind.
Como no me hiciste caso.
Yeah, that's
Yeah,
it.
no me hiciste caso. You just ignore me. You just avoid what I said.
But
I'll regret
you ignored me.
it.
Okay.
Pero
I want to say
no
it one more time.
me
Me
hiciste caso.
ignoraste.
Yeah, you can say
Me
that.
hiciste caso.
Me ignoraste, pero me ignoraste.
We take off the no on the.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. So what does hiciste caso mean?
That means you ignore me, or you didn't pay any attention.
It's like a way of saying you didn't pay attention to me.
Okay. That's what I wanted to hear was didn't, but you didn't pay attention or
Could
whatever. Yeah.
you say más de once instead of de una vez?
No, you can't. Once is 11.
Oh,
Yeah, you see, once.
sounds
Oh,
like
okay.
once.
Yeah.
I mean, you
And
say more
that's
than 11 times, mas de 11, but it wouldn't
once
be it
is.
once.
Es muy, muy específico, pero sí puede
Yeah.
ser.
Sí. Okay, Roger, what is number nine?
Ok. Le di tiempo más que suficiente para decidir. I let him enough time to decide. Give him.
More than enough.
Okay, more than enough.
Time to decide.
Like that.
Yes.
Say the English again.
I gave him more than enough time to decide.
Excellent. Great. Okay.
Just
Lady
to take away
Tiempo.
on that one. Oh, go ahead, James. I interrupted you.
No, anytime.
I was
Bryce,
just going to
step
say
in.
that the takeaway on that one was just, you see, I use más que instead of más que en vez de más de. This, it's not giving like a quantity.
And notice the word order, okay? So, is it possible to say lady más que suficiente tiempo?
Le di suficiente tiempo.
No, because más que suficiente is the adjective for tiempo. So it would have to go afterwards, right?
I think so. I believe that's correct, sir. Right. All right. It's modifying the tiempo, right? Okay. Yeah, okay. Don't let me get into a tangent, Anna. Stop and kick me under the
That's hard.
table. All right. It's time to party. Peggy, can you hear us now?
I can hear you now.
All right. Welcome to the party. How are you doing?
Okay,
I know it was hard to get on there, but glad you made it. Do you want to try this one, Peggy? You don't have to, but
Lo es el tiempo, tiene una fiesta.
okay, time to have a party.
Think of an hour. It's the hour in this case. Think of time as
Hora?
hour.
Es la hora? Or
Yes,
just hora?
es hora, es hora. Hora de festejar.
I bet that's new for a couple of people.
Yeah, I've never seen that verb. It hasn't been on Duolingo.
No, not surprising. Okay, to party. To party, believe it or not, is an infinitive verb, right? The verb for to party is, I mean, everybody knows fiesta, right? Right. Well, there's a
See,
verb for that.
why don't you use the la there? Es la hora. It's the hour.
So, de la fiesta.
Because it's less, it's not definite. It's not the time. It's
It's not the moment.
general. It's
Okay.
time to party, right? Versus, hey, like I'm looking at my watch. The time is now, es la hora. Right.
It's more than a comer. That's my
The
favorite meal.
movie.
Yes, right.
Time to be.
Okay, I like this one. And es la hora perfecta. Like we're being
To
specific,
see a movie.
right? It's the perfect time. Right. Great examples, Anna. Great. All right. It's party time, right? As opposed to it's time to party, right? It's party time. See these. It's just like English. There's more than one way to convey this, the idea, the thought. So I hope you review these. Go through this list when Anna shares it, and maybe listen to the video again, and go through these and say each one of these. Es time to party. Es hora de festejar. Es la hora de la siesta. Es la hora perfecta para ver una película. Es la hora de comer. It's party time. Es tiempo de fiesta. I should have Anna read all of these.
You did great.
I did okay. I don't know about great, but maybe okay. Okay, number 11. 11.
I'll do it.
Okay.
Esta lección es esta, no, esta lección es difícil de entender. And
Muy
it's
bien.
this lesson is difficult to understand.
It is, yes. Okay, so what are we learning here?
Just another structure with day.
Difícil. Is there any other way to say that?
Me cuesta entender esta lesión. You can say that, you have a
Okay.
hard time understanding.
We'll see, yeah.
Say, yeah, me cuesta entender, or me cuesta trabajo entender esta lección.
Awesome. It's hard work.
Why trabajo?
It's hard work.
What's me
It's
cuesta? Oh. Well,
hard for me. It's not literal.
yes,
No,
it's
it's not
not
literal.
literal. It's like saying it costs me, but it's not literal.
Oh,
This is
right. But why would you need to? Because me cuesta, this is hard for me. So why would you add the trabajo? Just to.
that's how it's and you'll hear that a lot. You'll hear people say
Okay.
me cuesta trabajo. You hear both ways, me cuesta entender esta lección y me cuesta trabajo. Entender esta, you'll hear both
What would
very
it be the
common.
same like when you say you are hard work? Similar?
We do.
Okay.
I work hard. I work hard to
Remember?
understand. Yeah.
So that would be me trabajo duro.
Yeah. Well, that would be something different. Trabajo duro para entender esta lección.
That would be hard. I work hard too.
Yeah.
Good. Okay, moving on. Number 12.
A mí es difícil para leer este libro.
Okay, it's a little bit hard to hear you.
I'm sorry. A mí es difícil para leer este libro.
Okay. You don't need the para in there.
Okay. Just a mí.
Para mí es difícil leer este libro. Say that whole sentence.
A mí es difícil leer este libro.
Good job. Okay.
Can I use Leo instead of leer?
Mm-mm. Es difícil leer.
Okay.
Now, the takeaway on that one is I just did a reverse from the other example. But because you see, I didn't have to use they there. For me, it's difficult to read this book. Now, if I said this book is difficult to read, este libro es difícil de leer, that's different. Now, that's one of those little things that, you know, you miss the day in the case that you need it. You know, I don't think anybody looks at you, you know, is going to look at you funny or anything. But
I have a question. The main sentence can be, it's difficult to me to read this book.
For me.
It's difficult for me
for
to
me.
Read this book.
Yeah, for me.
Yes.
Okay, let's write that. Read this book. Good job. It's difficult for me, para mí.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. Good questions. 13. I hope. What do I hope?
Espero que les dé otra oportunidad. Oportunidad de presentar una propuesta.
Good job.
I thank you. I hope that at the next opportunity, is that right?
Oh, I hope he or she.
Oh, sorry. Yeah,
that's fine.
I hope they have at the. I hope he or she. They give the okay. He gives.
So look at the last. Look at the last, Ken. What does the last represent?
Less. Okay. Like them, you know. They.
Yes.
Yes.
That's exactly.
So I hope she gave them the other or the you know the other opportunity. Or a different presentar una propuesta, present another proposal. Or like how I wanted to present. Okay, so I hope they. Dang, it's just hard to.
Okay, say the whole thing. Say this first word, Ken.
Espero.
Good, much better, much better. The first time you said aspero, we went. Espero, right? Good job. Espero que les dé.
So if you were to change it to I give them, would it be D-D-I?
I hope I give them another chance.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Les dé.
No, wait. Well, hold on now. If you're wait. Saying if you're saying doy for present tense, it's doy. It's doy, like I give it, well,
yeah, but the day is past tense, isn't it?
No, see, that's the reason why, good question. I did this one to put two different days, but they're two totally different days. The first one is day, the subjunctive.
Oh, because of the K, see.
It was because of your espero que. Anytime you say, you know, I hope this, I hope that, it changes to the subjunctive. If you know it's another subject, if it's another, you're talking about another subject. So that's a totally different day. You see, it's got the accent over it. And then the other one is opportunity. It's like the opportunity of presenting. But it's, you know, we don't say it like that, but.
What would just the past tense of gave be? Dio? No. Dio? I mean. Without the subjunctive.
Say what in English. Say what do you want to say in English? I gave them another opportunity or
they gave them.
So
they gave Anybody, I just wondered the simple
they gave
past
them
tense.
Les dieron.
No, he gave them. I'm sorry.
Oh, he gave them.
The
he gave them less,
day,
less
day,
dio.
Day, day. Okay, that's it. Yeah.
She Anna's Anna's
thank
giving
you.
All of these
L.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And what's L? L? What's? Oh, there we go. Da. Oh, okay. Oh, Lordy. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
But. D, D, stay, and then L. A, D. Okay. Dio. Okay, so I did it. Okay, Dio. That was. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anna.
You're
awesome. All right. I know everybody's going to want to download this document.
You bet.
All right, number 14. Who's up? Who's up to bat?
¿De qué estás hablando?
What are you talking about? Willis?
What are you talking about, Willis? She just gave the translation.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I will stop. Hands off the keyboard.
Sometimes you'll hear de que hablas.
Yeah, I think I would hear that. I think I hear that more. De que hablas.
Yeah, you probably hear de que hablas more. Yeah.
¿Qué dices también?
Right. What do you say? ¿Qué dices? All right. What are you saying? What are you saying? All right. Quince.
Let me try that. No
good.
Nos dimos cuenta de lo que pasó. We didn't notice what it happened or what just happened, maybe. We didn't notice.
Realize.
That has the same sentiment, but realize is.
Okay.
For dar cuenta. Is realize
okay.
Is what we use most. We didn't realize what happened.
What happened?
Right, past tense. What happened?
Darse cuenta.
So, dimos cuenta. Dimos is us, so that's where the we comes from. It's negative. We did not. And dimos cuenta is realized. So we did not realize.
Now keep in mind for the people not familiar with the structure, is it's the verb itself or the structure is reflexive. So like, you know, I'm sure you've probably heard someone say, no me di cuenta, for example. But it's reflexive, so just keep that in mind. You have to have the nos or the me or the te.
Mm-hmm. And dimos cuenta de. Why is this de important instead of just dimos cuenta lo que pasó?
In the right object. Direct object. No, direct object.
Okay. Is everybody cool with that?
Say that again.
I'm asking about this day. Why do we need it? Instead of just saying, dimos cuenta lo que pasó,
is
didn't realize.
Is that another one where it's a definitive about what we realize?
Anna said it's
pardon? What's
the
that?
what is the day? Dimos cuenta de. Is it direct or indirect or?
Yes. Yeah, it will be like nos dimos cuenta, okay, about what or what, you know. So, nos dimos, if you say nos dimos cuenta lo que pasó, it's just grammatically incorrect, okay? So you need a direct object or indirect object just to specify or complement this sentence and say, okay, me di cuenta que estuviste leyendo el libro. Me di cuenta que no te gustó la película, okay? O me di cuenta que dijiste que la comida o mi comida estaba salada. Okay, so you need to specify or complete the sentence with de. Otherwise, it's just going to be incomplete. That's what the direct object. So you are saying, then you are specifying what. That's how you use it as a direct object. It's like lo que also. Okay, it's the same use.
So the phrase actually is dimos cuenta de.
Me di cuenta de. Nos dimos cuenta de. Yeah.
That's a good way to remember it. Yes. Just put it together. Good.
Or me di cuenta. Is that what you said, Anna?
Me di cuenta is
yes.
I realize.
I didn't realize.
Right.
Or I realize. Yes.
All right.
Okay. We told them yesterday.
These examples are very negative. It's like if we're nagging someone.
Who are you mad at?
It wasn't me, okay?
No.
But yeah, he was mad
I put
at
some
something.
Of these because
what happened?
There are a lot of them are negative, but there are things that we say, you know, it may be even with a friend. You know, I give a friend a hard time.
Te lo dije 11 veces y no me hiciste caso.
Mm-hmm. We told them. The yesterday's easy, right?
Ayer.
Ayer. We told them. All right, Bev, how do we say we told them?
I don't know if it's les dijamos or dijeramos. I'm not sure. Dijimos.
There you go.
Okay. I don't know the past tense.
It's okay. Yeah. That's why you're here.
Sí.
That's great. That's great.
Dijimos. Got it.
Le dijimos.
But it'd be less.
Less.
Les can you put in say? Se les dijimos ayer.
Now, if you were to say, se lo dijimos ayer, like we told him it yesterday, se los dijimos ayer.
It would be los instead of les.
Oh.
What does that mean? Se los.
No, it's se, yes, yeah, se lo. I'm sorry. Se lo. Se lo.
What's the
se lo dijimos ayer. Yeah.
What's
this?
Like
we told
does that mean I know?
Yesterday. It's like we told him it yesterday. This, now, in this case, the say represents them.
Oh, okay. We told it to them yesterday. Them yes. Is, the say is them.
Oh, now, if you want to be specific, you can add, you know, a ellos, because technically, se lo dijimos ayer, it can mean we told him or we told her. Yesterday.
So would you, Bryce, would you normally put a ellos in the front or after dijimos?
I would put it after dijimos. I mean, if I were to say it, but you could say it in the front too.
Mm-hmm.
And say is them?
In this case, yes.
In this case.
Whoa.
I haven't got to
Tengo.
that Duolingo yet.
Yeah, because you can't say les lo. Tengo
There's no Lelo,
una duda
Lelo,
con el
no Lelo.
Lelo.
Lelo. You can't say
Tengo una duda con
Lelo,
el español
Lemmy on Stitch.
y el
What's it?
los.
Roger? Again, please, Roger. Roger.
Tengo una duda con el español y los. Porque si el escenario fuera que se lo está diciendo a una persona, que varias personas le dijeron a uno solo algo, sería, se lo dijimos ayer. Pero aquí es como que varias personas se lo están diciendo a otro grupo de personas. Entonces
Right.
no sería se los dijimos ayer. Complicado.
But that is a different sentence. This one, Roger, se lo dijimos ayer. It was
Cuando
se los, but yeah, this se lo versus se los dijimos. Se los, no, se lo dijimos. Se los dije, se los dije. Jesus Christ. Se lo dijimos ayer, se los dije. No, no, it's not.
veo como si fueran
No.
dos
Se
grupos de
los,
personas
se lo dijimos
entre
ayer, se
ellos.
los dije ayer.
We told
That
them.
is, se los
We
dije
told them.
ayer. That would be correct, but
It's a trap.
yeah, we told. So this will be more like se lo, we told them about it yesterday. We told her
Wouldn't that
about
be
it.
I told her?
Yeah, we told her. Se lo dije ayer, we told her.
Uh,
I
di,
told
dije,
her. Told her, we told
it's
her.
not dije
We.
is we. No.
No. No, we is se. Se lo, los. I mean, it's los. Se los. No. Se, oh my God. Se los dije. In this case, or in this one, is I
Yeah,
told
I
them
told her.
I.
I. And this one is I told them
We.
yesterday.
Se lo dije.
Hola. Se lo dijimos, we, right, we told him. Se lo dijimos, yeah, we told
Right.
him yesterday.
Roger,
Se lo
¿está de
dije.
acuerdo?
Sí, solo que me sigue eso.
¿Cuál era la oración? ¿Cuál
Son cosas
era la oración,
del
Roger?
español. Que son cosas del español.
En tu cabeza, ¿cuál
Es
era la oración
que
en español?
en mi cabeza el escenario es dos grupos de personas, ¿no?
Oh, sí, déjame
Entonces,
escribirlo. Okay,
llega
en español.
nosotros y ellos, ¿sí? Nosotros y
Exactamente,
ellos.
exactamente. Entonces,
Plural.
nosotros.
Nosotros y ellos. Plural.
¿Eso?
Exactamente. Exactamente. Entonces, eso en mi cabeza suena como que en español debería ser nosotros se los dijimos a ustedes ayer. Entonces, por eso la confusión. Pero no, es algo del español que de las dos formas suena bien y se entiende. Así que no nos metamos en ese hoyo de
No,
poner.
¿sabes lo que pasa? Yo creo, porque yo también lo he oído aquí, se los dijimos, pero no creo que sea correcto. Creo que lo correcto es se lo en singular. Y cuando usamos los, vos sabes cómo a veces modificamos el español y
Sí.
lo decimos rápido. Entonces yo creo que eso es más como una variante que nosotros hemos creado, pero que no es
Puede ser.
correcta.
Sí.
Yeah. So lo is one thing. We told them one thing. If it's los, we've told them more than one thing.
The direct
Anyway,
object.
let's move on.
Yeah.
Thank you. But isn't it wonderful, everybody, to listen to two Spanish speakers discussing and figuring it out? Gracias, gracias. Para mí siempre es muy, muy interesante. Les diste. This will be our last one. Bryce, is there? Okay, 17, 18, 19, 20. Really? Okay, we got to do number 20. How do we say number 20?
Perdón.
Realmente.
De veras.
De veras, de verdad, en serio. Or, you know, if you want to say seriously, you can.
De verdad.
Okay, de verdad.
De veras.
Mm-hmm. What's the rest of you? Verdad.
Did you say un poco?
What is the difference between veras and verdad? De veras.
Veras is you're telling somebody saying it, whereas verdad is the truth. It's a noun.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good. Veras, from what verb?
What is this verb?
Veras. Veras.
It's like truly.
Verdad, de verdad. Mm-hmm. It's just a way to say de verdad.
Okay. One more and then we'll be done. Number 17. Les diste las llaves.
You did gave them the keys?
Keys? Yeah. Did you give them the keys? Did you give them the keys?
All right. Good job, everybody. You can do number 18 and 19.
Just don't mix up diste and dijiste.
Don't mix up diste and dijiste. Diste and what did you say, Bryce?
Yes, I was saying don't mix up. I'm not saying that anyone would necessarily make, you know, confuse the two, but dijiste versus diste.
Right. Okay. Say and give. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Okay. I always ask this. Did anybody learn anything? Anything new? Algo de nuevo?
Anything.
Good.
Mucho.
Yes. Okay, Bryce, you knocked it out of the park again. Thank you so much for
thank
this.
Thank you.
Everybody, there will not be a meeting next week, next Wednesday, because of Thanksgiving, the next day. Anna and I and everybody are taking Wednesday and Thursday and Friday off. So enjoy. I hope everybody is blessed with family and friends. Even if you're in a different country, I hope you get a chance to... even if you don't celebrate our Thanksgiving, I hope you are blessed with family and friends during this time. Okay.
Gracias. Yeah,
gracias.
Thank you. Okay.
Yes.
Cool beans. I'm going to stop sharing. Anything you would like to summarize or say in closing, Bryce or Anna or anybody? Algo?
No, no.
Okay.
I'll try to remember to be here on 2 weeks from now.
Okay. You'll get an
email. We will send emails.
Emails. And if you are in the WhatsApp group, Anna sends a reminder in the WhatsApp group and also an email.
I set an alarm on my phone.
Good.
Can I get an invite for the WhatsApp group? I lost it. I let it expire. I'm so sorry.
Okay. Sure. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Adios.
What's the WhatsApp group? I bet Anna gets to it before I do.
Thank you, Anna. I appreciate it. You
I'm
rock.
Trying.
Me too. Gracias.
She got thank it. You. I knew she would. Gracias. I'm not even on the right page yet. And she's already pasted it. I swear she's in a different time warp than I am. Okay. Good job, everyone. Okay. Yes. All right.
Hey, chicos.
Have a safe week. Danib, is it Danib? Hold on. Okay. Everybody, thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank
she,
you.
She left. All right. Take care.
Good night.
Yeah.